We can't digest fiber, right? Wrong. Today we're going to look at how our microbiome, the bugs in our gut, can help us lose weight and avoid disease, and ways to keep our microbiome in good shape to improve our own health. This is three mind-blowing facts about your gut microbiome. Number one, we're less human than we think. We are supraorganisms made up of both human and microbial cells. And the microbes may actually be in the majority. Our genetics are even more skewed. 1% of the genes we carry, we inherit from our parents. That's the human genes in the human cells. The other 99% are in our microbiome, and we get them from the environment, like our mother's birth canal and breast milk. And all the genes in our body, human or microbial, can impact our health. Man, I feel like taking a shower. Why are all these bacteria hanging on to us? Well, they get their food from us. We have this idea that when we eat fiber, it goes in one way and out the other, unchanged. Nothing could be further from the truth. The soluble fiber in our food gets fermented and broken down by the bacteria in our gut. So our lunch is their lunch. So you're telling me these moochers are coming along for the ride and getting a free lunch out of me while contributing nothing? Oh, they contribute plenty. Fact number two. Your microbiome can help you lose weight. We think fiber is just bulk that fills us up. And that's part of it. But there's so much more. When bacteria break down fiber, they produce these incredible molecules called short-chain fatty acids. I know that's a mouthful, but just like insulin and dopamine used to be technical terms, and now they're mainstream and everybody knows them, I predict that in about 5 or 10 years, everybody will know about short-chain fatty acids, because their effects are pretty spectacular. Do you sometimes overeat and end up putting on a little bit extra weight? Microbiome to the rescue. Scientists watch volunteers at a buffet lunch. When people were given short-chain fatty acids beforehand, they ate less. And over time, they put on less weight, even though they had access to the same amount of food. They were just naturally less hungry. How does that work? Short-chain fatty acids cause the cells in our gut wall to produce hormones that reduce our appetite. Also, in animal models like rodents, short-chain fatty acids cross the gut wall and go all the way to the brain, directly influencing a part of the brain known as the hypothalamus to reduce appetite. We don't know if that happens in humans yet, but whether it's through the gut wall or directly in the brain, our microbiome and short-chain fatty acids help us feel satiated with less food. Still doesn't seem fair. I mean, I'm feeding them, carrying them around like I'm their Uber driver. They're squatters. Well, you might change your mind when we look at fact number three. Our microbiome helps us fight disease. So our microbiome feeds on fiber and produces short-chain fatty acids. We already saw that they can help with appetite and weight loss, but that's just the tip of the iceberg. Short-chain fatty acids also feed our gut wall and prevent leaky gut. They fight inflammation and reduce our risk of developing colon cancer. Maybe even more impressive, they can protect us against diabetes. Diabetes? Colon cancer, I understand, it's gut stuff. But how can these bugs change my blood sugar? Scientists took people with diabetes and fed them a high fiber diet rich in whole grains. The total number of calories was kept constant, and this was a randomized controlled trial, which, if you watched last week's video, is a very rigorous way to conduct the experiment and allows for a high level of confidence. Now, at first glance, you might think, this sounds like a bad idea. You take a diabetic who has high blood sugar and you give him a carbohydrate-rich food, like whole grains. Doesn't that make things worse? But the fact is, the opposite happened. The high-fiber, whole grain-rich diet was more effective at lowering blood sugar. And this effect was tied to specific gut bacteria. As the scientists explained, we observed more significant and faster improvement when more diverse carbohydrates were provided as added fibers in the diet. So how does this work? We saw earlier that fiber and short-chain fatty acids can help with weight loss. And in fact, people on the high-fiber whole grain diet shed more pounds, which can improve glucose levels. The authors suggest another possibility. Remember those hormones produced by the gut wall in response to short-chain fatty acids and that help us lose weight? Well, those same hormones also regulate insulin and glucose metabolism. Whether it's through weight loss or through these incredible hormones, it's amazing that the bugs in our gut can help us fight diabetes. And that something as simple as eating more fiber can get our microbiome fired up to do its job and get us healthier. We already knew from population studies that people who eat whole grains have a lower risk of developing diabetes. But that could be a coincidence. Maybe people who eat more whole grains eat less refined grains, or they have other healthy habits. These results from the randomized controlled trial suggest that eating more fiber-rich foods like whole grains indeed has a protective effect against diabetes, that it's not just a coincidence. It's a really powerful illustration that testing things directly can surprise us, and that we should always try to look for the evidence, not just assume. I'm starting to like these guys. Hey, microbes. You're all right. Welcome to the family. I'm not so grossed out anymore, all right? How do we get more of these little guys? Well, one extreme solution is to just get them from somebody else. There's a medical procedure where a stool sample from a healthy donor is transplanted to a recipient. It's called a fecal transplant. Fortunately for most of us, there are much easier ways. Growing a strong microbiome can be as simple as feeding it, including a variety of fiber sources in your diet. Good sources of soluble fiber include oats, barley, apples, strawberries, okra, and eggplant. But rather than obsessing over individual foods, just try to include a variety of whole unprocessed plants in your diet. Another great tool in your arsenal are fermented foods like miso, kimchi, sauerkraut, tempeh, or kombucha. They include fiber as well as bacteria themselves for a double whammy. You might want to be cautious if you have high blood pressure issues, as some of those are very high in salt. You can also make them yourself if you prefer, to avoid some of the additives in the commercial versions. Yogurt is also a fermented option. The problem with industrial yogurt are the additives, like sugar. But you can get plain yogurt, or you can make your own. And if you avoid dairy, you can even make it with plant milk. For more on gut health, check out this video, where I break down how I help my own mother overcome irritable bowel, or IBS. And in this one, we'll look at more strategies for weight loss.